Hello there, welcome to the Stephen School Alchemy YouTube channel. In my years of experience with alchemy, there's been old alchemical imagery and symbolism depicting sunlight used with mirrors and magnifying glasses. There's been people who have mentioned things about water and sunlight, and I've seen many. I've performed many experiments over the years and seen the results of many experiments. One of them is experimenting with water in a glass outdoors through the seasons, through the changing of night and day. And this particular glass, I did a new twist on this experiment because I sealed the lid shut. So what we're getting at is water and sunlight. What does it do? Is there a reaction? Some people claim, well, it's the Philosopher's Stone. But is it? Because if you look at the old manuscripts, some of them say, they mention things like the secret water stone of the wise and the Sapphic hydrolith, and then the alchemists speak of all these secret water, dry water not waiting the hands, a heavenly water yet not rainwater, a secret water that they call philosophical mercury, not elemental mercury, a certain secret water that without which nothing can be done. So there's that. However, in some of my experiments with water and sunlight, I have seen results. In this one, I wanted to check to see what the results would be. And in this particular experiment, I added water and then sealed the lid shut with good quality silicone. And it's been out here for a long, long time. To get an actual date, I would have to dig back through my videos, because I made a video about setting this up, and it was a long, long time ago. But I want to see if there's been any changes. And some things, as I've mentioned, when I conduct alchemy experiments, I've noticed a subtle or slight change in the experiment can have a drastic effect on the outcome. A big noticeable difference. So, in some of my previous experiments, the lid was not sealed. In some of them, I began with the jar empty to see if nature would fill it on its own, even with a lid. This water has been out here for quite some time in the sunlight and the moonlight, and by looking it appears as though something has formed in the water, and it's giving the bottom of the glass a mirror like reflection, making it look like mercury, like liquid mercury, when it does not contain any liquid mercury. But isn't that an interesting result? There is some particles that have formed. There's a haziness. But then there's also the color. Interesting. Where does mercury come from in nature? How does nature create it? A lot of people will get mad and say, well, it's an element. It just exists. It always existed. Well, I kind of think it had a starting point somewhere before it became an element. But in looking at that, it makes it look interesting, because this is just water. And alchemists spoke of water and secret water and mercury and philosophical mercury. And this is an interesting result I've not seen before. Why does the water look like mercury? I can see a haziness, a hazy type substance forming in the middle there. Nothing was placed inside the glass but water. Now, a lot of people theorize that water could hold the secret to the beginning of the metals. If that's true, would it make sense then that it holds the secret to all of them? I researched and posted on my community tab on my YouTube channel an article about is calcium a metal? And apparently it is. Here we are back again after a short intermission. The phone rang. So, looking. I have noticed like some specks and particles forming in the water. And since it's only a small amount of water, you know the amount has to do with it. But there they are in there. Hopefully they'll show up in the camera. There are little specks in the water. We have nature's rain cycle. And in the middle, there's kind of a fuzzy, hazy substance formed. And then we tilt the angle. We get the shimmer, reminding me of the words of the alchemists in their philosophical mercury and their secret water. This is just water. It never had any mercury. Let's see if we can get this angle a bit here. So, alchemy manuscripts talking about the secret water stone of the wise. Philosophic hydrolith. We can contemplate what type of water that is. This is ordinary water. A substance has formed. I hope it shows up in the camera. Like I say, the particles that are formed, it's not a lot. However, the quantity of water used affects it. More water condensed down would concentrate a higher yield, but this experiment has shown success in the fact of, by using water and sunlight, did a substance form, did something become manifest? And it did. It is from my experience that I know that when more water is condensed, the amount of material that becomes manifest is multiplied. In this experiment, one set amount of water was used and the lid was sealed. But with water and sunlight, there are some specks and flecks in there that were not there before, of an earth, if you will. And then there is the sheen, like mercury, leading me back again. How does mercury form? Does it actually form from water? If other metals form from water, why not mercury? Why not mercury? It makes sense. In the writings of Michael Synagogius, he says that water is the mineral seed. The seed of the minerals. We could argue, is the seed of the minerals the same as the seed of the metals? Or is it different? In the writings of Sendivogius, New Chemical Light, in my opinion, or my understanding, my interpretation of it, he suggests that they all come from the same source, the same beginning. That the one thing forms all the things, so that all the things are formed from the one thing, and the one thing can be changed depending on what it comes in contact with. But in alchemy, we hear quite often to take one thing and not many things. This is Alchemy of Stephen School. Do not try this at home, not for consumption. Check out the Stephen School Alchemy Forum on Patreon.com. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.